Okay, so first and foremost, we'll look at obviously your setup there. You can see obvious. Quite an extreme.
Yeah,
there's a lean. Yeah. That's, I mean, roughly speaking, the spine angle, the line of your spine is going to go through the top of your head, your hands, and the club. Yeah. Okay, if you were playing obviously with an iron or a shorter club, okay, your head would be less tilted again, your hands would be there, the club would be back here. So the same kind of line would be created. It's just with the driver, you're behind the ball. There you can see, I mean, I say it's a. That's a big old extreme lean there, okay? So we're going to try and go through that sequence. So there you go, I just got it, okay? So to establish that distance from the goalpole that you were questioning, how far is that? As we said, from club to club it's going to differ. From person to person it will differ. The different heights of the goalpole will be different. There's no actual number it's this far from the goalpole. Exactly. And again, when it's a flat light, it's one distance. Yeah, when it's I'll a uphill or a downhill or a tilted, there's going to be another difference again. So we always go through the process. First thing we do, put the club next to the golf ball. We know that's where it goes, okay? We grip the golf club, we set our spine angle, okay? Once you've got that, you then simply put your feet down for comfort to where you want to go. And that's taking you from sort of, we were just about putting the club down there, I guess at sort of 0 seconds there. You put the club down there, you're good to go. Two and a half seconds. You're ready to go in position. There's no thought, there's no shuffling around, there's no sort of where am I? Yeah. And there's a lot less going on in there.
Yeah.
Okay? And now you're in a position where you can just react, just allow the swing to take over. Mm-hmm. You know your natural shape of shot's going to be a little bit kind of left to right, which is fine. That last one there, we say moving about 5-10 yards in the air. Mm-hmm. It's now gone from being a vicious slice or a big shot to the right to just a little bit to the right, but then you're going to play to that. So if your fairway, if that's your target line there, for example, and you want the ball to end up here, and you're here, your golf ball would look something like that, okay? If you aim it straight, it's just going to keep going further and further right. So you play for what you think the shot's going to be. It's going to be a bit left to right in its swing. But when you're nice and relaxed there now, okay, with the golf ball, flex the knees a little bit less, so you look a bit taller as well in that sort of setup. Backswing position now, great shoulder turn now, good hinge of the wrist, lovely position there now, nice and angle with your the swing thing we discussed is certainly a lot better rather than being picked up. Nice strike of the golf ball there now. If we just watch your arm, everything fold up, that left arm now is hinging down and bending, your head's starting to come through, this foot is moving much better, the right hip, the right knee, your right arm, everything now is kind of going this way towards target, resulting in a good sort of finish position there. Up on your left side. So an overall, the movement there is very, very good. I think it's a lot easier to make as well when you're in a slightly less extreme kind of angle as you were before. So less knee flex, less spine angle, tilt, just to try and be a bit more neutral. And as we said, on a golf course, what we'll do is look a bit more next time, there's a line there. When you stand here behind the golf ball, this is where you're doing your thinking, okay? As in, what club am I going to take? Where am I going to go? What sort of shot am I going to try and hit? All those kind of things are going through your head, thinking, okay, right, I'm going to hit the ball 160 yards. It's going to go towards there, towards here, towards there, and that's what I'm trying to do. Then you choose your tool or weapon of choice, shall we say, for the task in hand. Once you then cross over that sort of thinking line, you just go club, grip, feet, look up for the target, there's the flag, and hit.
Robot is
it? Yeah, exactly. It's just basically like a sequence that happens over and over again to the point where you're just doing it without thinking about it. At the moment now, there's a little bit of conscious thought going on in your head about what am I trying to do? Okay. The more we do this sequence, this routine, and we get that distance from the golf ball consistent, you won't think about doing it. It will just happen. Yeah. It'll be a much better movement. You'll be more consistent with your setup. And if you can stand to the ball in a better position 10 times out of 10, the consistency of your shots are going to increase, obviously, because the same setup and a similar swing is going to give you a similar shot. If you've got a similar swing in three or four different setups, it could be four or five different shots you're going to get, and then of course every shot that goes one way or the other, you're going to start thinking about different shots, and you react every single time. Your brain's going to be thinking of all these different shots. That kind of makes sense then?
Yeah,
good. Excellent.